one for me, one for Mom, and...
Ah, balsamic mushrooms, meatloaf, chunky, sun-dried tomatoes.
And cardamom.
Ooh, taking a chance there, Chef Jim.
What's life without a little adventure?
Hey, what's up, guys? Welcome back to Binging with Babish, where this week we're taking a look at the meatloaf sandwich from Trollhunters, Tales of Arcadia, a sandwich whose contents we can only be sure contains these following three ingredients: sun-dried tomatoes, balsamic mushrooms, and the most curious ingredient, cardamom. I had a lovely conversation with writer and executive producer Mark Guggenheim, who told me he added cardamom to make the sandwich sound chefy, so I'm curious to see how this is gonna work out. But first, if you've ever watched this show before, you know if we're making a sandwich, we're starting by making bread, and I think a nice ciabatta is going to be the best bread for the job. We're going to start by making a pre-ferment of 177 grams each, bread flour and water, along with 1/16 of a teaspoon, or just a tiny little pinch of instant yeast. Go ahead and let that sit overnight for a bread with an improved texture and flavor. The next day we're combining 360 grams of bread flour, 1 packet or 7 grams of instant yeast, 7 grams of diastatic malt powder, and 12 grams of kosher salt in the bowl of a stand mixer. Ideally tiny whisking until homogenous, but I can't find the guy, before adding 152 grams of water, 35 grams of olive oil, and every last drop of our overnight pre-ferment, which we're going to mix together using the paddle attachment for about 10 minutes, until a smooth, silky, very sticky, but workable dough forms, which we're both going to proof and further develop gluten in. What? You know what I mean? In a well-oiled bowl. Just gonna stretch this guy into a nice taut ball before plopping him in. And if you are unable to locate your plastic wrap, or if you're trying to be a little bit more eco-friendly, you can cover this bowl with a plate, where we're gonna let it proof for about 2 hours. But during the first hour, we're gonna further develop its gluten by doing the old lift and fold thingy. That is, we're gonna lightly oil our fingertips, grab the dough from one side, lift it up, and fold it over onto itself, rotating and repeating about 5 times. Repeating this every 20 minutes for the first hour for a grand total of 3 times. Then we're letting it sit for another 45 minutes to an hour until doubled in size. Then basically what we're left with here is a dough with a very high hydration, high gluten content, and long pre-fermentation, so very chewy, big airy crumb, and lots of flavor. We're turning it out onto a well-floured work surface. We're going to gently try to coax it into a rectangle, and then cut that rectangle into 3 smaller rectangles, a little wider than you want your actual loaves to turn out. These are going to sort of squidge inward when they puff up. Arrange these on a well-floured piece of parchment paper set in a rimmed baking sheet, dust their tops with a little bit of flour, and then generously dust a clean kitchen towel with a whole lot of flour before covering and letting rest another 45 minutes to 1 hour. They shouldn't quite double in size, but they should puff up just a little bit, just enough to let you know that their heads are still in the game. All the while, we've been preheating our oven at 450 degrees Fahrenheit for an hour, with a pizza stone set on the middle rack. I'm placing these on the backside of my baking sheet so I can shuffle them onto the pizza stone and retrieve them using a pizza peel, just like pizza. Place them on a cooling rack, get rid of the parchment paper, and let them cool completely before turning into sandwiches. Plenty of time to make some meatloaf. First up, those balsamic mushrooms. I've got about 4 ounces of shiitake mushrooms that I'm sort of roughly chopping, sauteing in a little splash of olive oil with a little pinch of salt for about 5 minutes until they've given up all their moisture and are just starting to become crisp. And then I'm deglazing the pan with a few tablespoons of balsamic vinegar, letting cook for another 30 seconds or so and allowing to cool completely. Then comes the sun-dried tomatoes, which I'm going to turn into a glaze by rehydrating in about 1/2 cup of boiling water. It's about 4 or 5 large sun-dried tomatoes, covering once again with a plate and letting sit for at least 15 minutes until completely soft. Then I'm dumping these into a high-powered blender along with 1/2 cup of normal ketchup, 1/4 cup of honey, and a tablespoon of white balsamic vinegar to keep things on theme. Go ahead and puree those together, and this is when I realized that a little bit of oil that the sun-dried tomatoes came packed in emulsified the sauce into too light an orange color, so I'm going to add 2 tablespoons of tomato puree, something I probably should have done anyway, and 2 tablespoons of brown sugar, both to add some sweetness and to make sure that this glaze crisps up in the oven. That tastes delicious, so now we're moving on to the loaf part of our meatloaf. We're making a panade out of 1 cup of plain breadcrumbs, 2 large eggs, and 1 cup of buttermilk. Give that a little mix together, and then it's time to talk seasonings, and this cardamom has me thinking merguez. So 1/2 teaspoon dried garlic, 1/4 teaspoon cayenne pepper, 1/4 teaspoon allspice, 1/2 teaspoon cumin, and 1/4 teaspoon ground coriander seed. I'm also gonna add a little handful of finely chopped parsley, and this is an excellent time to pre-season with kosher salt and freshly ground black pepper. Now you might be asking yourself, where is the cardamom? And the answer is right here. We're going to process our own cardamom using a mortar and pestle. We're starting with a little handful of green cardamom pods that we're going to smash. Just a light smash. We want to break open the pods and make them spill out their seeds. Once you've smashed for a few minutes, you should be able to pull out the empty hulls of cardamom pods and be left with a couple tablespoons of dark ashen seeds. Now these we're going to more thoroughly smash into a fine powder. And you might be wondering, is this really worth all the effort? And the answer is kinda. Pre-ground cardamom, the kind you buy at the store, is inoffensive in the background of any recipe, but pretty gnarly to eat on its own. The freshly ground stuff, however, is floral and bright and fruity. It's really lovely. And we might only be sifting about a half teaspoon's worth into our meatloaf mix, but it's gonna make a difference. And because the sandwich was described as chunky by Tobes, I'm also gonna add three or four more finely chopped sun-dried tomatoes to the mix. I also almost forgot half a teaspoon of dried fennel that's gonna play real nice with all these flavors. Mix everybody together until they're good and combined, and then we're gonna need a bigger bowl. Because we are combining our herby spicy panade with one rib of celery, one medium carrot, and one half of one small onion, all passed through the largest holes of your favorite grater. Then we're gonna add our completely cooled balsamic mushrooms, and for a couple final hits of flavor, I'm gonna add a quarter cup of tomato paste, and normally I'd add Worcestershire sauce, but I think a teaspoon of fish sauce is gonna be a much more appropriate style of fermented fish goo. Mix that together, and then it's finally time to add the meat. 1 pound each, beef, veal, and lamb. We are, after all, going for merguez flavors, so a little bit of lamb is gonna add some of that nice gaminess we're gonna be looking for. Mix that up until nice and smooth. Don't worry about overworking it, that's gonna give your meatloaf structure. Then we're both greasing and lining our favorite loaf pan with parchment paper and filling it to the brim with our meatloaf mixture. Now, Jim's meatloaf came out looking kinda like a loaf of bread, and as much as I appreciate that aesthetically, I'm worried it's gonna make the cook time too long. So into a 350 degree Fahrenheit oven goes our nice flat top meatloaf for about 15 minutes, after which point we're gonna give it a hefty coat of paint using our sun-dried tomato glaze every 10 minutes until it's done. Another 15 to 20 minutes until its thickest point registers 155 degrees Fahrenheit and it's topped with a burnished, beautiful mahogany reddish brown glaze. At this point, we're taking it out the oven and letting it cool for about 10 minutes. That's not perfectly lined up. There we go. Let it cool in the pan for about 10 minutes, during which time we can bisect our homemade ciabatta, brush them down with butter, and give them a toast under the broiler for about 5 minutes until they're deeply golden brown. Once those come out the giant toaster, it's time to retrieve our meatloaf from the pan by virtue of the sort of handles we've made using the parchment paper. And then I've got this Armenian string cheese that I'm going to use for the cheese element of the sandwich. This stuff's not the easiest to find, so if you can't find it, just use Oaxaca or even mozzarella, it's fine. But before we build our sandwich, how did our meatloaf come out? And the answer is amazing. It's moist and tender, to be sure, but it also has all the funky flavors and spices of merguez. And the balsamic mushrooms and sun-dried tomato ketchup bring a much-needed zing. So now all there is left to do is pile it high atop our homemade ciabatta, stack it with Armenian string cheese, top up the sandwich, maybe throw some extra mayo or sauce on there if that's your bag. And then to make sure that the cheese melts and that everything gets nice and soft, I'm gonna wrap this guy in parchment paper and pop him back in a 350 degree Fahrenheit oven for 10 to 15 minutes to make sure that everything is roasty toasty. And of course, you could let it cool for 10 minutes if you're scared of hot, melty sandwiches. Otherwise, throw in your oven glove, bust out the bread knife, and let's eat. I'm starving. First, let's take a look at that cross section, hoping we get a cheese stretch. Yeah. Hang on, let's try that one more time with no clothes on. The sandwich, I mean. Oh my goodness. They don't call it string cheese for nothing. But let's dig in and see how it tastes. And it's absolutely amazing. It's a meatloaf sandwich on homemade bread with stretchy cheese. Wasn't sure how cardamom, sun-dried tomatoes, and balsamic vinegar were gonna work together, but hey, what's life without a little adventure?